Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Today we will discuss the mechanism of Beckmann rearrangement. Beckmann rearrangement converts aldoxime and ketoxime into amide, and amide are ultimately converted into amine by another rearrangement which is called Hofmann rearrangement. But right now we are discussing Beckmann rearrangement. So first of all, we will write the general reaction of Beckmann rearrangement. When you react ketone with hydroxyl amine, CH3, that is ketone, acetone, when you react with NH2OH, that is hydroxyl amine, H2 is removed from amine of the nitrogen, and oxygen is removed from ketone, so water molecule is left behind as a byproduct. So our ketoxime is formed, CH3C double bond, and that is called ketoxime. And ultimately that ketoxime is converted into that is also an acid catalyzed reaction. The mechanism of Beckmann rearrangement, as I told you before, that it is an acid catalyzed reaction. So acidic proton will attack the hydroxyl group of the oxime. Ultimately, in the next step, hydroxyl group will leave as water molecule, leaving behind positive charge on the nitrogen atom. Nitrogen atom is highly unstable while carrying positive charge on itself. So in the next step, that bond will fragment. Nitrogen belongs to the electronegative series, that's why it is highly unstable while carrying positive charge. Alkyl group immediately with bonded pair migrates towards that nitrogen to satisfy its positive charge to its electron deficiency. So in the next step, that alkyl group with bonded pair will migrate to that nitrogen atom with electron deficiency. Okay, now that positive charge will shift to that carbon which is more suitable. That carbon carrying positive charge is more suitable as compared to that nitrogen atom carrying the positive charge. So that intermediate is less stable because positive charge is present on electronegative atom, and that intermediate is more stable because positive charge is present on electron deficient carbon atom. In the next step, that hydroxyl, that water molecule which has been regenerated in the previous reactions, earlier reactions, is added to that carbocation, more stable carbocation in that form. As oxygen can only make two bonds, third bond is coordinate covalent bond, double bond NCH3. the next step, that proton will migrate towards this nitrogen and leaving, satisfying that positive charge. So next structure will be formed is that pi electron will move towards nitrogen. Nitrogen is more electronegative as compared to carbon. That's why that proton has migrated to that nitrogen atom. Okay, at the end, that hydroxyl will lose its proton, and that proton will go to the HSO4, H2SO to make H2SO4 again. That is, it means that H2SO4 is working as a catalyst. So in the last reaction, where actual product will be formed, that proton will make a double bond leave, and that proton will combine with H plus HSO4 to make H2SO4, and the product which is formed CH3 C double bond O and H3, that is a substituted amide is formed. I can make it more clear. The actual product which is formed is CH3, C double bond O, NHCH3. So from ketoxyne, a substituted amide is formed. That is, this rearrangement is called Beckmann rearrangement, and this is acid catalyst.